In the past 5 years, from 2010 to 2015, employment rates for age 25 to 64 has gone up to 80.5%, among the highest in the world. Unemployment rate at less than 2% overall and less than 3% for locals is among the lowest in the world. Income growth was broad-based. Real wage went up by 3% in real term a year, not just the medium wage, but the bottom 20 percentile as well. Profile of jobs has continued to improve. Local PMET's employment now accounts for 54% of our total local employment. So these are good employment outcomes for our workers and for our people. The next 5 years will be much more challenging. We're going to see a drop in the growth of the labor force, a sharp and a structural drop. The growth in our local labor force will drop by more than half, from an average of 55,000 a year in the past 5 years to just about 20,000 a year for the next 5 years, so a drop of more than half. Likewise, the growth in our foreign workers will drop too, also by more than half, from an average of 55,000 per year too in the last 5 years to just 20 to 25,000 a year in the next 5 years. So put together, the Singapore workforce will continue, the growth will continue to drop. From 4% a year in 2011 to 2014 to 2% last year, and likely to be around 1% by the year 2020. So a drop of 4% to 2% and to 1% by the year 2020. This has great impact on the future employment landscape in Singapore. The days of more than 100,000 job growth a year are over. It's simply not sustainable. So with no gain in productivity, we have moved from a 4 plus 0 equal to 4, 4% growth in the Singapore workforce, plus 0% growth in productivity, to give us a 4% GDP growth during the year 2011 to 2014 on the average. Last year, it dropped to 2 plus 0 equal to 2. 2% workforce growth, 0% productivity, to give us a 2% growth in our GDP. Question is, what will happen next? From 4 plus 0 equal to 4 to 2 plus 0 equal to 2, what is going to happen next? Will employment outcomes in the next 5 years be better or worse? I can think of three possible scenarios: the good, the bad, and of course the ugly. The first scenario, we are unable to transform fast enough, continue with zero productivity growth, continue with manpower-led growth of more than 100,000 jobs a year. So MOM, we have no choice. We do a U-turn, relax on our foreign manpower, and that's what many employers are asking for. So from 4 plus 0 to 2 plus 0, we'll now go back to 3 plus 0, right? Because we let in more foreign workers to make up for the slower growth in local manpower. With 3 plus 0 equal to 3, yes, we have 3% GDP growth. But what happened to our local foreign workers ratio? It will continue to drop from the 2 to 1 today, maybe to 1 to 1 one day, and beyond that, Singaporean locals will become a minority in our local workforce. Singaporean core will be weakened further, and in fact, the local-foreign divide will deepen further. And that's why I call this an ugly scenario. The second scenario, to avoid this ugly outcome, MOM can stand firm. No U-turn in our foreign manpower policy, continue to moderate the intake of foreign manpower. But without breakthrough in productivity growth, we will move from 4 plus 0 to 2 plus 0 to eventually 1 plus 0 equal to 1. So in other words, a low growth will become the new norm. In fact, hovering around stagnation. If that happened, it's a matter of time that the unemployment in Singapore will go up and wage growth will stop. And I call this a bad scenario for all. The third scenario is for us to recognize that technology is changing the nature of jobs, and global competition is changing the nature of investment. So instead of manpower-led growth, 100,000 new jobs a year, we go for manpower-lean growth. We speed up transformation. Instead of going for larger quantity of jobs growth, we go for better quality of job growth. So step by step, sector by sector, we move from high value added to value creation, from value creation to value multiplication, then we can return to positive productivity growth again. So instead of going for 4 plus 0, 2 plus 0 to either 3 plus 0, which is an ugly outcome, or 1 plus 0, which is a bad outcome, we should strive for 1 plus 2, 1% growth in our workforce, plus 2% growth in our productivity to give us a 3% growth. So 1 plus 2 plus 3 is the good outcome that we must strive for. The challenge for us is how to make it happen. Along the way, if we are more pro-business and less pro-worker, we could end up with a strong economy but a weak Singaporean core. If we are more pro-worker and less pro-business, we can have a strong Singaporean core but in a weak economy. Neither is good because growth cannot be sustained. Eventually, we'll go downhill. So only way for to succeed is for us to be pro, to become more pro-business and more pro-worker, both at the same time, so that hopefully we have a manpower lean and more productive economy with a strong Singaporean core.